In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can take a black and white bitmap, convert it into vector artwork, and then convert it into a rhinestone pattern. So what we have right here in CorelDRAW is we have a black and white bitmap. And this was started as a JPEG file, just downloaded this from the internet. And you notice if I zoom in, you can see the various pixels. This artwork is composed of pixels as opposed to vector lines. So we need to convert the artwork into vector lines before we can apply the rhinestone patterns. So the easiest way to do that is just to select the image and transfer it over to StoneCut. So we'll click on the cut function. That's going to transfer the image over to StoneCut. And then I'm going to use the contour function to convert this to vector line artwork. So we'll go over to Tools, we'll go to the contour function, and we'll pick our settings. So the first thing I need to do is select a color for my contour line. So we'll go ahead and select a color. We can make this pink. And once we've done this, we can keep that as the standard color. What we're also going to do is we're going to keep the interior elements. So all this white area here, we want to contour inside of that as well. As far as contour offset, we're going to set that to 0 because we want it to go right directly over the colors in the bitmap. We don't want that to go slightly larger or slightly smaller. Under corner shape, we're going to pick normal, or we can also round off the corners or cut the corners. So we're going to go ahead and click on normal, hit calculate, and we've created the vector line. So we're going to go ahead and delete the original bitmap, and then we're going to take a look at these vector lines. So we'll just grab the zoom tool and we'll zoom in here. So there's our vector lines. You can actually see the various nodes in the graphic. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to isolate the interior elements as separate elements. And the best way to do that is to select the entire graphic, go to Design, click on Break Combination. See what we've done? We've broken the combination. I'm going to go to the contour view by hitting F9. You can see those lines are still there. They're just separated. So what I want to do is select all of them. We'll just marquee select around them. So I'm just going to marquee select, or I could shift select by holding my shift key down and selecting them. And then I'm going to change my color layer. So we'll go over here and we'll make this color layer pink. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to combine these into one unified object. We'll go ahead and click on combine. And then we're going to change the object order. So if we go over here to F9, you can see the blue area is in front. So what I can do is select the blue area, go over here to view and say to back, and we've moved that back. Now here's a production problem that we've created. Because this object right here is very close to this object, if I outline this with rhinestones and I also outline this with rhinestones, what's going to happen is we're going to get overlapping stones. So I need to create a little bit of space for myself. And the easiest way to do that is just to select this interior element, go to Tools, and use the Outline function to inline this object. We're actually going to inline it. So instead of having an outline go around the perimeter, we're going to have an inline go inside. So I can check here, inline. We're not going to modify the corners. We're going to delete the original object, and we're going to give it a new color. In fact, we'll go back and just use purple here. So we'll use amethyst. Go ahead and click on OK. And I've given myself a little bit of space. There you go. Now the next step would be to go ahead and create the rhinestone pattern. So I'm going to select the blue layer here. We're going to go to macros, and we're going to select place rhinestones. We're going to pick all of our settings. So we'll go ahead and use an orange stone. We'll do a half a millimeter between each stone. We'll go ahead and turn on the collision recognition. And then what we'll do is we'll click on execute. There we go. So you can see how we've created the pattern. Now let's say we'd like to make this pattern slightly larger. We're just going to go ahead and undo this. We'll hit Control Z. All I need to do at this point is select the entire pattern, go over here on the property bar, let's say make that 8 inches, hit enter, and we've resized the entire pattern. So there we go. Let's go ahead and apply that setting again, and you can see the various spacing that's created. Now, one of the areas that we need to take a look at, because we had a very tight spacing, we had this tight spacing here in this area right here. And you'll notice all the intersecting stones are marked as gray. And the reason they're marked as gray is under color collision recognition, we have them marked as gray right here. Now, if I want to delete those, the easiest way to do that is go to the Objects, Docker. You'll notice all the intersection stones are tagged as intersection. What I can do is just select that layer, hit delete, and then if I want to do any manual adjustment, I can just come in here and manually adjust that. And that's taking care of all those intersections. Now the next area we want to work with is the purple area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the blue area, or we can just turn that color layer off if we'd like to. We'll just go ahead and delete it by selecting it and hitting delete on our keyboard. And then what I'll do is I'll select the purple layer, go back here to macros, we'll pick a different color. In this case, I'm going to pick blue. And then we're going to use exactly the same settings. And we're going to go ahead and click on execute. I'm going to get rid of these intersecting stones down below by going over to objects, clicking on intersect, deleting those intersects right there. And then we can do any cleanup that we want to on the graphics. So we can zoom in here. Looks pretty good, actually. So we'll go in here, maybe delete that stone there, delete that stone there. If we want to turn the purple layer off, actually we can do is we don't really need that stone, or we can add one over here just by moving it and right mouse clicking. There we go. And we can turn the purple layer off. So we'll go over here to layers. We can find the purple layer and just right mouse click on it, say not visible, and there's our rhinestone pattern. And that concludes this tutorial lesson.